This is test number 3 on the Hamtronics receiver. This is a temperature test. I'm going to vary the temperature of the receiver from very cold up to very hot over a period of time. At the moment, the temperature of the receiver is sitting around 12 degrees. And there's quite a weak signal going into it. And I'll adjust the signal down until the mute closes. That's the close point, and then the open point. Okay, so I've got those two points marked. Now I'll cool the receiver down and repeat that same test. I've cooled the Hamtronics receiver down and the temperature is let's say about -3 degrees, and I'll do the same tests that I did before. I'll wind the signal generator down. Mute's dropped out at exactly the same place, and I'll wind the signal generator up, and it's open at the same position. I'll leave the receiver running. I'll just make sure we're on the right frequency. Just adjust it spot on and do the test again. Yep, mute drops out at the same point and it comes on at the same point. So there's been no significant change in the receiver's performance. The sensitivity is the same, the frequency it's receiving on is the same, and the mute setting. The mute is the most crucial part of a repeater's receiver. It has to be stable, both the power supply wise and, very importantly, temperature wise. We all know the problems or suspected problems that repeaters have where it gets cold, the mute opens or closes harder or whatever. Well, this one's shown no significant change in the mute setting, and I'll just read the temperature again. It's gradually warming up, -1. So I'll let it warm up and then we'll do some heat tests on the Hamtronics receiver. The receiver started to warm up and the temperature now is about 7 degrees. I'll do the same test on the mute sensitivity. The mute's closed at the same point. And it's opened at the same point. I'll let the receiver warm up some more. The receiver's warming up and it's currently sitting at around 12-13 degrees, and I'll do the same test for mute sensitivity by winding the signal generator down. Same point, and wind it back up again. Opens at the same point. Okay, using a hairdryer, I've warmed the receiver up a fair bit. Sitting around 26 degrees. And I'll wind the signal level down again. Very slightly different. So the mute went off slightly earlier than before, probably in about 1 dB difference. And it came in at the same point. I'll warm the receiver up some more. I'll warm the receiver up quite a fair bit more. Sitting around 35 degrees. And I'll wind the signal level down again. Exactly the same point it did at below freezing, and I'll wind it back up again. And it opened at exactly the same point. I'll warm it up even more. I now have the receiver up around 40 degrees C, and I'll do the same test on the mute. Same point on the signal generator, wind the signal back up again. And the mute opened near enough to the same position. Temperature's probably come down a bit. Now it's still sitting around 40 degrees C. I'll just do one more, take it a little bit higher. I've got it up to about 43-44 degrees. And the same test again with the mute. Slightly less sensitive. Bring the signal back up. Maybe a dB difference, if that at all, RF-wise. I'll show you the signal generator now, what I was actually doing. This is my homemade signal generator, and what I was doing, this is the RF level here, and I've marked two spots where the mute was opening and closing at normal room temperature. I gradually wind the signal generator down, very slowly, and at that point there, it varied from about there to about there, but there's almost no difference in the level. It's very, very small adjustment. And then I'd wind the signal generator back up again for the mute to open. And around about there it was opening. You could probably hear in the audio there was very little difference in the signal level. There is hysteresis built into these mutes, and it's quite deliberate, meaning that the point at which the mute closes as I wind it down is different to the point at which the mute opens. And that's deliberate. So that's a rough test of the temperature stability of the receiver and the mute between below freezing up to about 40 degrees C.